Bleach marketing has been insane in Japan. So let's go through them, shall we? If you guys haven't noticed, Japan has been killing it with its marketing, essentially carrying worldwide marketing for us, which is maybe a good or not bad thing, we're not really sure. But there have been some big players in the game of marketing, as well as many different cool things, as well as magazine leaks, as well as campaigns and expositions, as well as PVs and TV shorts. So let's get off to the nitty-gritties of this, because we have a really cool Bleach Memorial Edition key visual with Ichigo in the front with the new key visual from the studio, and then all the little like episodes in the background, which I thought was a nice little collage, really cool. For some reason, Aaron Yarrow, my good friend that is a BBS YouTuber, Bleach Brave Souls YouTuber, apparently found Aaron Yarrow within the first 10 seconds of me sending it him, which is dedication to the craft. But again, Baruka still had two more images than Aaron Yarrow, so suck that, bitch. What happens when you choose best girl, fellas? I'm sorry, I don't make the rules, I just enforce them. So yeah, other than that, we get a memorial page and we get a really cool other color page as well, kind of going through each arc up until the passing of Blue War arc. So again, Shueisha with their magazine is always doing some really cool awesome bits as well. We also get some really cool things as well as merchandising, such as metal plated cards, and also an interview from Kitani and Senna Rin, who is doing the opening and the endings of Bleach, talking about how it was basically their dream to be in Shonen Jump, a dream to be a part of Bleach, and really not really much more than that, talking about how they made the feeling of what they felt with Bleach into the song, and they were surprised that it was taken and accepted for the Bleach anime itself. Not really too much about how they were approached in terms of the creativity of the song, but again, you know, sometimes in these magazines you get little or nothing and more so a personal thing, which again, if you are a fan of these artists, you will appreciate it. Though for me, I just felt it was, I could take it or leave, but still, nonetheless, I do appreciate it. And I'm just really excited to see what their songs are going to look like visually, as well as hear that ending song, because we haven't heard the ending song yet from Senna Rin. So the Kitani opening, it's grown on me. I love it. I've got to listen to the full version that was leaked, and I can say honestly, I'm a fan. I don't know if it's top five, but I'm a fan. Maybe the visuals and the cleaner audio will really hit for me. And hey, according to Kubo himself, it was an opening that he felt was the best. So clearly, I mean, I'm already digging the music itself, so I'm really interested to see what the opening's like and seeing what I can see what Kubo sees. Other than that, we also have a really cool campaign in terms of marketing in regards to Bleach Brave Souls, completely changing their layout of the home screen and its character designs to a certain degree, kind of fitting the new models that we have in comparison to the old models that we had from the old Bleach anime, giving it that new Taguchi style, which again is much appreciated, from, you know, its artwork to all the way to game character models. They're doing some really cool events if you don't play the game, such as like free multis and free five stars. So again, if you don't play the game, maybe now is the best time to get involved into it, as well as giving some exclusive accessories during the dates of when the anime is airing, so to say. As well as that, you get some BBS advertisements as well. That is going to be happening in between the episodes, as they're going to be doing some trailers. So that's really cool that K-Lab are putting their money into it and investing into the show themselves, as well as having a website revamp that you can go check out as well. That looks really cool. Again, can't wait to see a new Baruka unit, because it's going to be the bunny outfit one, and you know, it's over once we see that. And trust me, it really gets better than this, because we also have Coca-Cola doing its own marketing campaign, and I was extremely surprised that Coca-Cola got involved, because again, you know, Coca-Cola is a massive, massive corporation. I can't imagine just generally how much was involved in that campaign itself. So they have dropped a sick opening, or a sick visual, PV, whatever you want to call it, a trailer for it. They did a teaser and then they announced it a few days later. The Bleach Soul Burst, I think it's called Soul Burst can Coca-Cola, and what does it taste like? We don't know. Hopefully I can import it. I don't know how I'm going to, but I'll generally try, and I'll maybe do a review on Twitter. So if you don't follow my Twitter, go in the description, go follow me over there, and I'll let you know if I ever get it, and what it tastes like. What does Soul Bursting taste like? I don't know. But again, the visuals for this trailer goes absolutely nutty. And I just love how the Japanese know that the OST, the original soundtrack, being number one, how much that is loved across worldwide. I think it's undisputed that number one is probably one of the best OSTs that any anime has ever had. And that's a big thing. Hazel Fernandez, mwah, beautiful. And last but not least, we get an amazing TV spot. Now, of course, there have been two TV spots, but the second one was really things that we had really already seen, to be honest, so not really anything exclusive in regards to that. However, the first TV spot that we got had some few changes and a new cut or scene, if you want to classify it as that. Again, not very long, as TV spots aren't going to be, but we get to see at the very start of the TV spot the Gold Ichigo, which if you haven't watched the first PV or the pre-animated trailer, you will see that Ichigo does his purple Getsu Gaten Show. Of course, that has been changed, as expected it was, because again, it was a pre-animated trailer and they were going for aesthetics rather than canonicity, so to say. So we get to see like this gold aura following up with the gold or yellow Getsuga. So again, that looked really clean, really nice, and I prefer this obviously than the purple. I know people wanted the purple, I know, but you know, it's better, just take it, it's better. And of course, at the end as well, because we'd seen the majority of the clips towards the end, we get to see this really cool red lighting of the sun coming down. I would imagine the sun's coming down on Karakura Town, going into a nighttime of Ichigo looking fierce as this black either blood or shadow is maybe disappearing Iburn to the Von Dan Reich again. So that's my interpretation of it. I think maybe it's changed slightly than it was in the manga, not really sure, but it's either blood or it's either the shadows consuming Iburn back into the Quincy world, so to say. That shot, absolutely beautiful. I love the lighting effects on that, and I love the serious tone that Ichigo gives and just how beautifully drawn it was. But there's not really much more to say on that other than it looks cool. Now, of course, as of the recording of this video, there has been a 1 minute preview leak, and I'll be talking about that in a separate video. So please make sure to like and subscribe here for all the exclusive stuff and all the new things that we can talk about as well. And just as well, I did forget to mention that today, a few minutes before recording this, we did also get a new type magazine, which then gave us some really cool stuff about Bleach. I guess if you're a new person, it would be cool, but if you're an oldie like me, you know, it's not really anything new. However, there was something interesting that was mentioned within this magazine, is that the majority of the magazine is basically just talking about the strength of characters, right? Saying like, oh, Uryu's here to help his friends, Ichigo's here, but the main focus will be around his friend group. And then it talks a little bit about Yamamoto versus Yuha. For Yamamoto, it kind of specifies more on the fact of like, you know, this is so serious that Captain Yamamoto is involved. And then you also get Yuha Baha, which is talking about, we finally get to understand the reveal of who this guy is and what his relationship is with the Shinigami. And then we have some really cool voice actor Q&As in regards to talking about of what they think. It's like it's not power scaling, but talking about, you know, how strong certain characters are, like who they thought was the strongest. Some said Toshiro, talking about they can't wait for him to get to his, you know, yeah. And and some said Kenpachi. Taguchi actually said like he's really excited, specifically, obviously we know he's gonna love Memories of the Memories of Nobody for some reason, but yeah, he talks about how essentially like when he gets to that point, because so many people love it and he loves it, he can't wait to get to that specific part with Toshiro. But also something Taguchi also said within this magazine as well, is that when you watch the first episode where we see first two Shinigami, the no-named Shinigami, well, they're not no-named, but you know what I mean, the new Shinigami that people aren't so used to, they talk about how their introduction into the first half of the episode is his direction towards those two characters in general that you see on screen, is that he wants to use those characters as if the characters were the audience. So we're seeing everything through their perspective, we're seeing the world through their perspective, and we're also seeing the appearance of our main characters through their perspective. So when the heroes come and save them, Taguchi wants the characters to react the way that the audience is going to react to seeing these characters for the first time, especially again after so many years. So that was a really cool direction of how he wanted to go in with those two characters in general. Oh, and did I mention Coke was also getting a vending machine as well? That's pretty cool, right? That's pretty cool. Of course, there's much more marketing practices going on, especially with the Bleach Expo and the cafe collaborations that I could go into more, but there is just so much that Bleach is doing. Oh, and of course, the train station, key visuals plastered all over the trains as well, which is amazing. And not to mention the Shinjuku TVs just plastered across the wall promoting Bleach as well as Chainsaw Man and Spy Family. It's a TV Tokyo advert, realistically, but still, regardless of what, that's up there until like the 16th of October. So it's going to be there for quite a while. And of course, the massive poster on the, what's it called? Shibuya 109. I forgot the name of the building, but it's 109 and it's a clothing store and it's right smack bang in the middle of Shibuya. And it's just massive. And before Bleach was on it, there was Chainsaw Man, which was just like two characters, or like Denji in his Chainsaw Man form. And that was cool. You know, it stood out. But as everybody knows, red and yellow are prime colors. And the absolute massive scroll portrait that they had on this building being completely enveloped in red was so eye-catching, you couldn't take your eyes off it from a marketing standpoint. You know, red and yellow again always contrast with the human eye, and they really bloated that whole entire building in red, and you can just see Ichigo in the middle and it's right there. It's very out there to see. You can't really dodge it through, because I believe the Chainsaw Man colors kind of blended in with the building's colors to a certain degree. I'm going off memory. But yeah, it was wow. I was really impressed with the image choice that they chose. So Japan are killing it, and there's just so much more to talk about. But yeah, that's kind of the main things I wanted to talk about. So if there's anything else that you may think I've missed, tell us in the comment section down below of what you may or may not have seen. And yeah, Japan are killing it. So yeah, like I said, like and subscribe. Of course, with that being said, you guys of course have this fine Debian Hansen, and as always, people, peace out.